Hey folks, I can't show you all of the palette. Because this board is larger than the 10 by 8 inches, that makes it possible to see the bottom of my makeshift palette. I'll tell you what the colours are. I've got cadmium red, which you can see, ultramarine, burnt sienna. Below that I've got some sap green, I don't think I'll need that. Some cadmium yellow pale and some yellow ochre. I try to remember to tell you what colours I'm using. I'm going to mix up some good dark, bit of that red, plenty of blue. I want quite a dramatic sky, a bit of white. I'll use a mixture of knife and brush technique in the sky. Get some red in there. Now I've got some nice cad red. I'm going to use some oil to blend all this to make it quick, but not a lot of oil. Let's get some blue, light blue, bit of red. The great thing is that on Facebook I've got all the paintings, every painting that I've done on YouTube is on Facebook, and I've got about 2,000 of them, and I can work from them. I can use them as my models. So my work is, although it might be similar, it's original, totally original. Got this rock here, bit of a headland there, and the sea. Maybe I should just raise up that horizon. Well, you know, I should probably go up to there. Okay, that'll do. Get some white. This way you can vary the colours. We don't want plain white. Right, okay. Get a brush. Could use that one. I want a cheap brush. That'll do. This hardly any hairs left. So a bit of oil, and let's just start to blend. And I can put some impasto over the top of some of this. Wobble wobble. Not just totally random. No great thoughts of what's going on. That'll come when we start to model. Now, you may always bear in mind you need to counter change lights against dark all the time. If you get that right, that's half the battle when you're painting. Subjects will come after that, subject matter. Right, I've got a bit of red in there, a bit of ochre. Red, bit of yellow. Okay, clean the brush. Then I can start to. If there's too much oil on there, it will all just go to one colour, and that's what I don't want. I want a sort of definite dark against light. So blue, red. So no oil on that, just straight in. Right now, excuse me. Ugh. Any bristles, just get rid of them. I'm using a bit of cad yellow, pale, and cad red to give a warmer look on that horizon. And clean the brush. Now you can get lovely soft. Never know quite how it's going to turn out. Get off. Right, now we'll So it gives a. It looks like we've used the knife more than we have. Well, that's what I hope, anyway. So we've now got a knife painting in the sky as well as on the land. Okay, well that'll do. I'll clean my knives and we'll start, we'll put a horizon in. Now, a bit of green. Grey green, see, now I've done the brushwork, I can use paper to clean my palette knife. It's the ultra, the well, the yellow ochre, not the yellow. Okay, that'll do. Let's get that rock put in first. So, burnt sienna, load of colour in. counter change, separate the planes of the rocks. A bit of green on the top of that. Not having paints grey, I'm having to make my darks with the ultramarine and sienna, burnt sienna. Gonna create the illusion of detail. Some light on there. Any old light will do. Okay, well that's looking all right. I'll go back to that. I'll want to get in this distant headland or this headland. Blue. Now these lovely warm colours in there. Just using bits of burnt sienna, raw sienna, a bit of green, paint's grey, burnt sienna, ultramarine, and and ultramarine. Ultramarine, coat the yellow, pale, and sienna, burnt sienna. It's a lovely colour, isn't there? A bit of cavity in there. Okay, so a bit of light. Now we want the rocky bits. I'm not aiming for any realism. I'll model on these. Right, now we're going to get some ochre-y stuff in here. I just get lost in these. Oops, sorry. Move that. Maybe that's a little bit better. Right, now we want to do this beach. I'm going to use some burnt umber to mix in with the sand and stuff. So I'll put that there. Because we have shadow. Oh, more tissue. let's lose a bit of that. Just rough that up a bit. Just work it in. Bit of shadow sand. I can even use the ground colour for this because this is, it's why I like using this MDF. You could get a bit of a surface on it, but not that coarse. But it just has a bit of tooth and you can just sort of drag over it. It's lovely. I can use this technique. It's very much like brushwork. There's a lot to cover up, isn't there? But I will put in a couple of rocks and a bit of detail in it. I'm rushing now because it's getting to my bike riding time. Just a nice bit of blend in there. Right, I need a bit more white and a bit more ochre to finish off, and then we'll tart it up and put a bit of detail on there. Got a mossy on it. No, yellow ochre, sorry. I use raw sienna for watercolour and yellow ochre for oil painting. Mainly because the raw sienna in oil tends to be rather darker, and the yellow ochre in watercolour tends to be rather opaque. I think I'm going to take up this hill here. Just rough it up a little bit. Right, I'll feel a bit better. I'll do some detail on that. Let's get this just working it in. Ooh. Great. Times I do that, I go and scrub my nails, yeah? How to change. Right, well, this is entirely made up. We've got a bit of knife in here, It's nice. I'm just going to put a bit of bright. Catch in there. And well, I could overdo that, so I'm going to put it in the mount. Move my palette. I'll cover that with a bit of cling film so that I can use it again. Right, let's put a couple of tacks in it. Ooh, did you touch it? Oh dear. That's a bit of all right. That's just a bit of my wood on there. Oh, well, there we are. That's it. Another Cornish beach. All my beaches are made up, but they're based on memories from many holidays in Cornwall and the North Cornish coast. Absolutely gorgeous place. It's just a little bit of a bit of light on there. Okay, so I hope you like that, folks. Enjoy the rest of your day and stay safe. See you soon. Bye bye.